This shot is impossible. You just can't be so close, have so much depth of field, and still maintain a smooth bokeh in the background. To create something like that, you need to use a technique known as focus stacking. In this video, I will tell you how to take this shot with any type of camera and show you how easy it is done with Fujifilm cameras. Leave a like and let's take the impossible shot. It can be done with any camera and any lens, although some gear will make your life a little easier than the other. The trick is in post-processing, but this part is actually very easy. Image editing software will do everything for you automatically. You just need to feed it with good source material. You need multiple photos, tens or even hundreds. That software will combine into one impossible picture. Here is how to get it done. First step, set your camera on a tripod. If you have steady hands and a very quick camera, you can try to shoot everything handheld, but a tripod or some kind of stability rig is highly recommended. Even on the go, you can find a way to fix your camera in one spot. Second step, set up your scene and lighting. In order for photos to stack well, you need to have even exposure across all the frames. Remove any inconsistent lighting source. Avoid having bokeh balls in the background. They will give you a headache on editing. Third step, set all the exposure settings to manual. White balance too. You don't want anything to change between shots except the focusing point. Set the aperture wide enough to get the correct exposure at low ISO, the background you need, and a sharp image without much chromatic aberrations. Focus manually on the closest part of your object and take a picture. Move the focus slightly further so the depth of field overlaps the depth of field on the previous shot, and take another picture. Move the focus, take a picture. Repeat until you get to the far edge of your object. You can do this with any lens, but it will be easier to stack photos later if the lenses have minimal focus breathing. Editing will also become much more complicated if there is a noticeable fringing in the photos. Because of that, macro lenses are usually the best option for this and will benefit the most from using such a technique. We are using Fujifilm 30mm f2.8 macro. This is my review of this amazing macro lens, by the way. Another tip, it's better to take more photos than you actually need. For macro, that can easily be a hundreds of photos. Just watch out and don't move your camera. Of course, this can be a little bit tedious, but it's worth it. On some cameras, you can make it much easier by automating the process with a special focus bracketing mode. Fuji has it on GFX, XH series, X-Pro 3 and all the XT models starting from X-T2. For Sony, you can get this in A7 R models, and Canon introduced it with Canon RP and then added to R5 and R6. Your lens must have an autofocus to use this feature. Here is how to do it on Fujifilm. Turn on the bracketing shooting mode on a command wheel or by pressing the drive button. Then go to shooting settings, choose drive settings, bracketing, pick focus bracketing and press right. Choose manual and right again. Here you can set the number of frames. You can set more than you think you need. The process can be stopped manually at any time. Then you can set the steps. It is the amount the focus shifts between frames. This amount is relative to the calculated depth of field of your first shot. 1 is 20% of your depth of field, 5 is 100 and 10 is 200. You can set it to a value between 1 and 10 with the default on 5. So every part of your object will be in focus on one of the shots. You can set steps to lower than 5 to get some overlap for better results. The last setting is the interval, how many seconds the camera will wait between taking a shot, from 0 to 10 seconds. Don't set it to 0 if you are using mechanical shutter. There will be vibrations because of the shutter. On the other side, longer interval time will greatly increase the total time you need to take all the pictures, which can introduce shake from the environment or lighting may change. That's why I like to take such photos with Fujifilm X-H2S. With 30 frames per second with the electronic shutter, this camera is perfect for that technique. Once you have all your shots, it's time for post-processing. Edit your photos in your RAW editor of choice using the same settings for all photos. Stacking can be done in many different software suites. I personally tested it in Affinity Photo and Photoshop, and prefer the second option. It gives you a little more control and produces better results. Here is how easy to do it in Photoshop. In File, choose Scripts, then Load Files into Stack. In the dialog, press Browse, navigate to your images, select all of them and click Open. Here you can check Attempt to automatically align source images if you moved camera a little between shots or lens have focus breathing, and then click OK. Now select all the layers by clicking on the top layer, then shift clicking on the bottom layer. Navigate to the Edit and select Auto Blend Layers. Photoshop will create a mask with the best part of each photo and render the final photo from all of them. If something went wrong, you can edit each photo and each mask. And that's it! I can't wait to see your results. Please tag me on Instagram when posting pictures taken with this technique. It's really inspiring to see the impact of your work. And let me know in the comments if you want more educational content like this. See you in the next videos!